In the second round of Reykjavik Open Tournament, my opponent was Nils Ake Malmdin. I played e4. He usually opens with c5, and after knight f3 I was expecting knight c6, but for today my opponent chose g6. And after d4 he played bishop g7. Well, c3 is probably a good move against black's strategy. And after bishop g7, white can play d4, c takes, and after exchange, d5, e5. And black's bishop on g7 is a bit passive. Black might try to play d5 instead. But I don't know what happens after e5, maybe this is a possible move. Okay, this is another interesting possibility, but I decided to play d4 since I was preparing for position that my opponent plays. I wanted to play this opening today, but I was surprised on move 3 by bishop g7, and now I didn't know too much about this position. Of course, I can probably play c4 and just enter normal position. Maybe black has some options. Maybe he can try to make some original move order, but I don't believe black has something much better than transposing to normal lines. In any case, I remembered a game from 13 years ago. I played the World Junior Championship, and one of the most important games of that tournament was a game Bruzon-Malakhov. Bruzon had the white pieces and he won the game in good style. And the game went like this: queen takes c5 and knight a3. Well, to be honest, I didn't remember what happened later, but I just knew that this was a quite dangerous position for black. I even used this once myself as black, and I quickly got into trouble in the opening against Sergei Dolmatov. Okay, now one important thing is that black cannot take the pawn on c3. After b takes queen d2, queen takes rook, white plays knight b5, knight a6, knight back to c3, and now white simply wants to castle and play bishop b2 and win the queen. Well, black maybe has some ways to save his queen, but he's going to lose much material in any case, so this position is lost for black. And my opponent played after knight a3, knight f6, which probably is the best move. And I remember now that in Malakhov's game, Bruzon played knight b5. I thought the game went on like this. Now white wants to play bishop e3 and then just take the pawn on a7. And maybe Malakhov played something like b6. And I'm not really sure what happened later. But during the game, I remembered some line with e5. I spent maybe 20 minutes or maybe even half an hour here to try to remember these lines. And after knight g4, I played queen d4. Now I thought black would have to exchange queens and play knight c6. And okay, probably white has several options here. White's position looks really good, but maybe black can fight still. I'm not sure that black should lose the game. In any case, Nils played here move d6, which looks like a logical move. He's defending his queen and he's also defending the knight on g4. And now I took on c5. I considered another move here, bishop b5 check. It's a normal motive in Sicilian when this knight on g4 is without without enough protection, and black needs his bishop to cover this, to cover his king. So now if black would play bishop d7, white can exchange and just take the knight. So this is not an option. Also knight d7 is not possible, and if black doesn't want to lose the castle, he has to play knight c6. And then I can take on c5 and take on c6, destroy black's pawn structure and just play bishop f4. Now my idea is to play h3 on the next move. Black's knight will be forced to go to h6. Then I will probably castle long and try to attack the weak pawns on c6 and c5, especially the one on c5. I thought this position was also better for white, but it looked even better to just exchange the queens and play knight b5. I want to go to c7. This is of course deadly. So black has to protect this square with his knight. Well, maybe it was possible to play a move like king d8, but it looks bad after bishop f4. I want to play h3, then castle with tempo, and well, black doesn't have time for something like this. I can just check on d1, then he has to go bishop d7, and maybe I can push e6, I'm not sure. Okay, this needs to be checked, of course, but probably it looks ugly for black, really ugly. My knight will go to c7, and if black plays a6 here, then I check again on d1, probably bishop d7, and now I thought maybe even knight a3 would be okay. I want to play h3. Once black's knight is on h6, my position will be much better. So I thought maybe black would try knight c6, and then I can jump to c4, protect my pawn. I want to jump to b6 and win a piece, and my position is great, probably winning. So okay, king d8 doesn't look very good, and knight a6 is the normal move. And now I have to play bishop f4 to protect the pawn on e5. And now my idea is to play h3, then put my bishop to c4, castle long, maybe play g4, bring my other rook maybe to e1. Okay, my moves are easy to make. And Nils played here bishop e6, which this move makes some sense. He doesn't let me play bishop c4, and also he's eyeing pawn on a2, so if I castle, he might take this pawn. Okay, h3 is very normal. I played quickly. Knight has to retreat to h6. And now I was searching for a while for the best way to continue. One option was knight g5. Bishop comes to d5. And now I was thinking also about c4, bishop c6, and f3, for example. But I didn't like, I really loved my pawn on c3. It's limiting black's knight. And also black bishop on g7. So I didn't want to push this pawn without some special need. And I was considering many other moves, like bishop e2, bishop d3. But somehow I couldn't find some clear plan how to continue. My position looked very good. Of course, both of black's knights are in badly placed. And finally, I saw the possibility knight d2, and somehow quickly I started to like this move. Knight's going, knight, actually my pawn on e5 is safe now, and it doesn't need too much protection, and the knight is going to a much better square, c4 or maybe e4. And while also black's bishop is a very important piece, it protects d7 square, and Now my idea is to exchange the bishops, and then after I castle, my rook will come to d7, and black can never put his rook to d8 because I will just exchange rooks and then take the pawn on a7. So I really like this idea. And okay, black decided to castle. It's probably a normal move. And I just played the bishop to c4. Now, okay, if black takes, I just take with knight. I thought this position was already very close to winning because my knights are extremely powerful and black's knights are terribly placed. So I will just increase pressure, put my rooks to d file, and if necessary, maybe push a4, a5, or knight can sometimes jump to a5. There are many plans. And well, bishop d7 is the move that my opponent chose. And there was another move that I was thinking about, and it is rook ad8. Actually, this move was maybe the best chance. I thought like this because, okay, now I can, now black wants to take on d2 my knight, and I have to do something. I can make a move like b3 or bishop b3, but b3 I didn't like because it weakens c3 pawn, and one day maybe bishop on g7 will become strong. Bishop b3, I was not sure what happens after c4. Then this very bad knight will come to c5 and maybe d3. Well, I didn't want to let this happen. So mostly I was thinking about bishop takes e6, pawn takes e6. Now my bishop is under attack, so I should probably exchange on h6. Now somehow black has some activity, and I have two obvious moves here, knight c4 and knight f3. And both of them have some drawbacks. If I go to c4, black can play rook f4. Black must play quickly here, because if I just manage to play a few improving moves, then my position will be completely winning, because black's structure is terrible and his bishop might become really weak. But black can maybe try to play rook f4, attacking my knight. I have to protect with b3. Now I saw the check on e4, and my king has to go to f1. Well, I stopped around here, but still maybe my position can be really good. I don't know. I'm not sure. But somehow I was scared. I didn't want to give all this activity to my opponent. And other option was to play knight f3 here. This move looked safer. And well, but now black can maybe push c4, and his passive knight from a6 will jump to c5 and then to d3. So okay, I still thought I had advantage here, but somehow I thought this was black's best chance. He had to go for something like this, because the way he played it just let me improve my pieces and win the game easily. So after bishop c4, my opponent moved his bishop back to d7. Now sometimes he wants to take the knight on b5, then play knight c7 with tempo, then this knight might go to e6, or maybe he will push e6 and put the knight on d5. So I played a4. Generally it's a very logical move in this structure, and I'm protecting the knight. Now anytime black takes, I will take with a pawn, and black's position will be terrible because a7 will be permanent weakness. And actually black must not take this knight ever. So he played bishop c6, which is a normal move, I thought, attacking the pawn on g2. And I played just f3. I thought it would be good to play against black's pieces. Actually, both of his knights are on the edge of the board, and his bishops are also not doing great jobs, so I'm trying to limit activity of all his pieces. And well, it's already difficult to find the move for black. Rook on f8 might be needed to protect f7. Rook on a8 must protect a7. Knights cannot move. If knight comes to f5, I'll just push g4 and knight will be forced to go back maybe. So black decided to go king h8. I'm not sure if this move is useful. Maybe one day he wants to push f6, but it's not so easy to achieve, so I don't know. But okay, it's one of the normal moves, I guess. And well, here I was thinking if to push maybe h4 or maybe even g4, but somehow I decided finally to go for long castle. And maybe this was not the best move, because black now can play knight f5. Okay, still I think my advantage is not small, but now I cannot push g4 because of knight h4. My pawn on f3 is under attack. If I protect it, black has a very nice move, knight g2. And this knight is attacking my bishop. Also, it wants to come to e3 maybe. So I didn't want to play. I definitely didn't want to play like this. So after knight e5, I already had my move ready. I played h4. I take away this square from black's knight, and I want sometimes to push h5, or I want to push g4, knight h6, h5. This would almost win the game. And I was expecting Nils to play bishop h6 to exchange some pieces at least. And after exchange, well, now h5 isn't too dangerous. Black can push g5 or just come king g7. So I was thinking to play g4 and limit even more his knight on h6. Now I don't have some very fast plan. Okay, maybe, for example, after king g7, which looks like a logical move, maybe I can do something like bishop d3. Then exchange the bishop on e4. Then I will have much better knights, plus this possibility to enter with my rook on d7. And okay, my advantage is big, I think. Okay, I still think black has some chances to maybe save the game, but it's not going to be easy at all. But I thought the bishop h6 was the best move, and I didn't like at all the move that Nils played, h5. Because now I have a nice move, knight e4. Well, I accept this change of pawn structure, because in this case my rook will enter on 7th rank and just collect many pawns. So this is actually not an option for black. And well, what can black do? I really don't know. Maybe bishop h6 again, but his position looks weak, really. I don't think he can save the position anymore, even with best play. He played now knight h6, probably to protect the pawn on f7 in advance, and maybe move the knight away because maybe g4 is coming. And now I had two options here that I saw. One was to play knight g5, because I was wondering for a while what was going to be my opponent's next move. I couldn't see a single move for black here. Knight from h6 cannot move. Bishop on g7 cannot move. King is not going to go to g8 probably. It looks like a worse square. Rook on f8 has to protect the pawn. Rook on a8 has to protect other pawn. Knight from a6 cannot go anywhere. Bishop on c6, it can only go to e8. It doesn't look like a logical move. And pawn moves I couldn't see at first. Then finally I saw move e6 actually. This is the only move probably that black can play, the only meaningful move. Otherwise I can continue to improve my position, for example double rooks on d-file or something similar. So when I saw this move, well, still of course my advantage is huge, but then I decided just to play bishop d5 and exchange the bishops and enter with my rook. I thought probably I was going to win some material really soon. And okay, if black takes, I take. Rook d7, not possible to stop. So now Nils played knight back to f5. Sorry, he played king g8, yes, king g8. Well, it's probably okay move because now bishops are going to be exchanged and he's getting closer with his king in advance, having nothing better to do. Well, maybe it was possible now to play some other moves because I don't know if black has any useful moves, but I was happy with the position after bishop c6 and I thought there was no need to complicate. Just I returned to a3, my knight is coming to c4, where it will be placed perfectly. And pawn on c5 I thought was gone. Black has more problems, it's not his main worry even, this pawn. So now he played rook to d8, which maybe is a normal move. And after knight c4, okay, I think he made a mistake. He played rook to d5. Well, position is very difficult, but rook d5 probably loses immediately. I saw a nice trick here, and well, maybe I can ask it as a question. So I was thinking here between two moves. One was knight e3. Well, idea is to make his rook go somewhere and then exchange, because I don't want to take on d5 obviously, not only because I will lose a piece, but also I'm improving his pawn structure. So knight e3 is one possibility. Then after rook goes to d8, I can maybe push g4, or I can exchange rooks and bring other rook or something like this. Another option was knight a5 to attack the pawn on c6. Well, if I go knight a5, black has only one way to protect this pawn, and this is rook c8. So now you can maybe spend a few minutes, think about the position, and try to understand which one of these two moves is better. So knight a5 is the winning move here, because black cannot protect the pawn with rook c8 because of a small tactical trick. Knight takes to c6. Black has to take on d1, and after rook d1, well, I'm already a pawn up and attacking two more pawns, and if black takes on c6, there is check. Black cannot cover because of bishop h6, so he has to move his king to h7, but then knight g5 is a checkmate. So Nils saw this trick and he decided not to lose this way, but now his position is already hopeless. he played knight f5. I just grabbed the pawn. And now he took on d1. Well, I shouldn't take with the rook, probably because then I'm going to lose this pawn. Still, my position must be winning, but I thought it wasn't necessary to give this pawn and maybe another pawn on g2 soon. So I took on d1 with a king. And Nils played rook c8. Well, probably he had some better moves here, but he already had little time and okay, position is really lost. I grabbed another pawn on a7. Check wasn't so bad. I just moved my king to c2. He played rook d5, attacking pawn. Well, not really attacking pawn, most probably. But I protected it anyway. And after king f8, I decided to push g4. H takes, pawn takes. Knight has to go back to h6. I exchanged on h6. Well, in this position, I thought there should be a better way to win the game. But I was thinking, spending some time, and then I finally decided to just play rook d1 and win simply by exchanging pieces. After the exchange, Nils played bishop f4. Maybe his idea was now after b4 to sacrifice some piece, let's say like this, and then hope to maybe somehow eliminate all my pawns and make a draw in position where I only have two knights and he has nothing. But okay, of course this is impossible. Still, I decided to go king e2 and bring my king first to f3 and only then to push my pawn. After king e8, I played king f3. Bishop c1, b4, and after the exchange on b4, Nils decided to resign the game. Okay, now let's check a bit with Houdini. So we can start around here. Bishop c3, Houdini likes the move, but as I said, it's actually a trap and black is lost, so knight f6 is probably better. And now okay, this position has to be studied, and I believe it is very risky and probably not good at all for black, but white needs to know what he has to do. And if you are curious, you should study this opening. I believe it will not be very difficult to find the best moves where black will be in real trouble. I played e5. Probably this move is a bit worse than maybe knight b5. I think it's maybe giving away part of my advantage, but I just wanted to have a bit simpler position since I wasn't ready and I had to accept the possibility that maybe my opponent was ready, and he really was, as he told me after the game. He looked at this line, he was preparing, so probably this was not so bad idea. And d6 is best according to the machine. Well, queen c5 is okay, and knight b5 is okay. Knight a6 is the only move. Bishop f4 is normal. Bishop d7. Black has a few moves, but in any case, he is already seriously worse. So okay, bishop e6 is just one of the best moves, one of the, they all have similar variations. h3 I'm sure is normal. Knight h6. And now knight d2. Well, I really like my move and I don't understand. I wouldn't change it. I would still play knight d2. Although machine gives points, many more points to bishop e2, which is also a normal move, or maybe a4. I agree, they're all normal moves, but okay, I'm curious what machine will say about knight d2 after I play it, because I'm sure it's a good move. So okay, 0.39, not happy. I want to see 0.50 maybe, but probably it's not going to happen. Oh, 0.27 only. So let's see what machine suggests. Bishop d5. Something like f3. And bishop c6. I still don't understand why this position is now not... Okay, now some changes. Okay, now it's already starting to look normal. So okay, machine is somehow underestimating my advantage. I have such feeling, because black's pieces are really terribly placed. Okay, I'll accept also the possibility that bishop e2 is maybe stronger, but I still like my move. And after castling, bishop c4. Let's see now what happens after rook d8. Okay, of course I have many options, but let's say I exchange and play knight f3. What's this position like? Black should push c4, I thought. Knight a3, this move I didn't see, I must admit. I'm attacking the pawn on c4, but black can maybe protect with rook f4. Well, my advantage not so great here. Even machine admits, so I don't know what I would do. Maybe I wouldn't go for this position, maybe I would just play one of the other moves, like b3, bishop b3 or something like that. Still, of course, my advantage is significant. Okay, bishop d7. a4 is good. Bishop c6 I'm sure is okay. Now f3. Castle is a bit better, according to computer, but... Okay, I don't know. Might be. I'm not sure. I liked my king in the center, where it can go to long side sometimes. But okay, maybe short castle is better. Machine can be right. And I was considering this move seriously, because also my rook on a1 maybe is not so bad. Protecting on a4 also, if black takes this on b5, this rook will be great. So maybe the short castle was a better move. But I think there's nothing wrong with f3. King h8. And now short castle, not in the long castle, not in the list. But okay, I think it's not a bad move as well. My position is great, and yes, okay, this move is also okay. Knight f5 was okay. h4 also okay. but some of my advantage became smaller according to the machine. Still okay, I don't know why exactly it is smaller. And let's check the most critical line, bishop h6, exchange and g4. I'm curious, how is black going to play here? F5. Probably g5. Knight goes to f7. Well, I'm not sure how exactly to continue here. Maybe rook to e1. Maybe black can hope for some counterplay on h-file after king g7 and h6. But okay, still, of course, his position is problematic. But this was better way to continue. Bishop h6 was better move. And h5 probably wasn't great. Knight e4 was okay. Knight h6 wasn't great. Bishop d5 is good. King g8, okay. It's already too late, I think. Exchange and knight a3, and position is must be close to winning now, or winning already. Rook d8, knight c4 is okay. Rook d5 probably a mistake, and knight a5 is correct. And now my position is winning. Let's just check if everything was okay until the end. Knight f5, knight takes c6, rook takes d1, king takes d1. Computer likes much more rook takes d1. Okay, position is winning. I don't have many doubts that I will win, but is rook d1 really so much better? What happens if black just takes on h4? I play bishop g5, this is the trick. And black cannot take on g2 because he will lose the knight. It would be nice to see such thing. So black will have to go back to f5. Now I can push g4. Black has to go back to h6. And okay, obviously now he's being destroyed. Also, I'm up on materials, so this was really probably the best way to continue the game. Okay, king takes d1 is good as well. Rook c8, knight takes a7, rook d8, king c2 is normal, rook d5. Knight c6 normal, king f8, g4 is good, even bishop h6 is good. I thought maybe this was not the best, but I just wanted to simplify the position a bit. And rook d1 not top, but okay, even this is maybe the simplest way really to win the game. Bishop f4, b4 was also good, king e2 is good as well, king e8, king f3, bishop c1, okay, position is completely winning. Well, I can be happy with this game. I was maybe lucky to get so good position after the opening where opponent's pieces cannot play, but After this, I didn't make, okay, maybe one mistake was that I didn't take on d1 with my rook, I took with the king, but I think position was already winning.